My name is K. Simhachalam. Welcome to online classes, Padmavati Junior College. Today we discuss the topic formation of stationary waves. Formation of stationary waves in a string. So we already discussed about classification of waves and characteristics of waves, already discussed last class. So now we discuss formation of stationary waves in a string. So first of all, we discuss about stationary waves. Stationary waves. Stationary waves means when two progressive waves are having same amplitude, same frequency, and same wavelength, traveling opposite direction one each other, they have formed stationary waves. They have formed stationary waves are called as stationary waves. So let us consider one of the progressive wave traveling along a medium. So that is the equation of progressive wave along x positive direction, that is y1 is equals to a sin kx minus omega t. The equation of progressive wave along x positive direction, that is equals to y1 is equals to a sin kx minus omega t. So next, the wave is traveled along the media, some exit point the wave is reflected. So the reflected wave equation, the progressive wave equation, that is said to be y2 is equals to, that means that is along x negative direction with positive amplitude, y2 is equals to a sin kx plus omega t. So this is equation 1. This is equation 2. Okay. So according to principle of superimposition, that is equals to y is equals to y1 plus y2. So here y is said to be resultant displacement, y1 is one of the progressive wave displacement, y2 is one of the progressive wave displacement. According to the principle of superimposition, that is y is equals to y1 plus y2. So now what is the equation of y1? y1 is equals to a sin kx minus omega t plus y2 equals to a sin kx plus omega t. So according to the formula sin a minus b and sin a plus b, so now open this formula, a sin kx cos omega t minus cos kx sin omega t plus a into, this is sin a plus b, so sin a plus b formula, sin kx cos omega t plus cos kx omega t. So the formula sin a plus b, sin a plus b formula, sin a plus b formula, that equals to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. Cos a sin b. This is the formula of sin a plus b. So now sin kx minus omega t and sin kx plus omega t as the formula sin a plus b or sin a minus b. So now we can open that formula sin kx cos omega t minus cos kx sin omega t. And sin a plus b, that open the formula sin kx cos omega t plus cos kx sin omega t. So now multiply the amplitude a. So that is equals to a sin kx cos omega t minus a cos kx sin omega t plus a sin kx cos omega t plus multiply amplitude. So a cos kx sin omega t. So here the negative terms a cos kx sin omega t, here plus a cos kx sin omega t. So these are opposite terms. Now this is cancelled. So remaining terms a sin kx cos omega t and a sin kx cos omega t. So therefore now the resulting displacement, that can be written as 2a sin kx cos omega t. 2a sin kx cos omega t. Here a is said to be amplitude, k is some constant, that is equals to, k is equals to 2 pi by lambda. 2 pi by lambda. Here t is said to be time, omega is angular velocity. Okay. So here the stationary wave is depending on, the amplitude of the stationary wave is depending on the displacement of particle, that is x. Displacement of the particle, that is x. So let us see, x equals to 0, lambda by 2, and 2 lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, etc. So here the amplitude is 0, amplitude is 0, the position of the particle, the position of the particle is minimum, that is said to be node point, that is said to be node point. Okay. So the amplitude, the stationary wave is depending on, that is the amplitude is depending on displacement of the particle, that is x. Here x is equals to 0, lambda by 2, 2 lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, there it is. So here the amplitude of the particles is 0. Amplitude of the particle is 0. That point is, that position of the particle or the position of the wave is said to be node. Node. Okay. So next one, x equals to lambda by 4 and 3 lambda by 4 and 5 lambda by 4. This is odd number. So here the displacement of the particle or the amplitude of the particle maximum, that is, that equals to 2a, that equals to 2a, here 0, here 0, here 2a. Okay, so here the amplitude is equals to 2a, that position is said to be anti-node, that position is said to be anti-node. So this is node point, this is anti-node point. So the node and anti-node points are formed in a stationary wave. Already we discussed last class. Okay. Stationary waves, in a stationary waves, nodes and antinodes are formed. So here node and antinode are discussed according to stationary waves. So now we discuss formation of stationary wave. Formation of stationary waves. Formation of stationary waves in a structured state. Okay. Now we discuss formation of stationary waves in a string. So let us consider one of the string length L, length L and linear density. And linear density mu under a tension T. Let us consider one of the string. The string having length L and linear density mu and under a tension T. Now the string is fitted into some rigid supports. Along this way, let us see. So this is one of the string. So the string is fitted into two rigid supports. So this is one of the string. So now the string is vibrating. The stationary waves or progressive waves are formed. So along this wave is formed. The wave is incident and reflected, and second end of the rigid supports, that wave, reflected wave is superimposes. The reflected wave is superimposes, then that is said to be one of the stationary wave. Okay, this is antinode point, this is node point. Okay, so this, the length of the string is said to be L. So this is denoted L equals to the length of the wave is L equals to lambda by 2. L is equals to lambda by 2. That's lambda is equals to 2L. Here lambda is said to be wavelength. That is lambda is equals to 2L. Okay. So according to wave velocity, the formula of according to wave velocity, V is equals to nu lambda, nu is equals to V by lambda. Here nu is said to be frequency of the wave and V is said to be velocity of the wave and lambda is said to be wavelength of the wave. So according to the wave velocity, already we discussed last class, wave velocity, V is equals to root T by mu. And lambda is equals to 2L. So according to wave velocity, the formula V is equals to root T by mu. Here T is said to be tension of the string. And mu is said to be linear density. What is the meaning of linear density? Linear density means the ratio of mass and length, or mass by length. Okay. Now we substituting the velocity and wavelength, the equation of frequency. That is mu is equals to v lambda. Let us see. Mu is equals to 1 by 2L into root T by mu. So this is fundamental frequency or first harmonic. This is called as fundamental frequency or first harmonic. Okay. Let us see. First one will repeat. So consider one of the string length L and linear density mu under a tension T. Now the string is fitted into two rigid supports. Now the string is vibrating. So the stationary waves are formed. So let us see. So this is one of the string. Then the string is just vibrated. The stationary wave is formed. Wave is incident. Another end or second end of the rigid support. And after that the wave is reflected and the two waves are superimposed. Then the stationary waves are formed. So therefore, here the length is said to be L is equals to the distance between two node points lambda by 2. therefore L is equals to lambda by 2. Lambda is equals to 2L. V is equals to nu lambda. Nu is equals to only V by lambda. So we already discussed wave velocity. V is equals to root T by nu. So lambda is equals to 2L. So these two equations are substituting the frequency equation, that is nu is equals to 1 by 2L into root T by nu. So this is called as for fundamental frequency or first harmonic. Fundamental frequency or first harmonic. Okay. Now the string is vibrated. The string is vibrated two modes. That is this one. This one. Okay. So this is L. So this is lambda by 2 and this is lambda by 2. This is lambda by 2. Now we discuss about in this way, according to first one, first harmonic, and second one harmonic we will discuss. L is equals to lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2. So here LCM 2. 2 1 2 2 is equal to lambda plus lambda, that is equals to 2 lambda by 2. L is equals to 2 lambda by 2. R that can be written as L is equals to 2 lambda by 2, that is equals to 2 lambda is equals to 2L. Lambda is equals to, so here lambda is equals to 2L by 2. 2L by 2. So according to frequency equation, frequency mu is equals to V by lambda. Here V is equals to again root T by mu and lambda is equals to 2L by 2. So now we discuss frequency mu is equals to V is equals to root T by mu and lambda is equals to 2L by 2. That is equals to mu is equals to 2 by 2L into root T by mu. Here mu is equals to 2 into 2 by 2L into root T by mu. So let us see. So here 1 by 2L into root T by mu is equals to fundamental frequency. That is equation 1, fundamental frequency. So therefore, now this is, it is denoted mu 1. Mu 1, mu 1 is equals to 2 mu. Are you understand? So here 2 by 2L into root T by mu. So 1 by TL in 2L into root T by mu is equals to fundamental frequency or first harmonic. So now that can be written as mu 1 is equals to 2 mu. So this is called as second harmonic or first overtone. This is said to be second harmonic or first overtone. First overtone. This is said to be fundamental frequency. Or zero overtone. Zero overtone. Okay. So now the string is vibrating three modes. Now the string is vibrating three modes. Let us see. So this is three modes. So this is one of the lambda by 2 and this is lambda by 2 and this is lambda by 2. So the total length of the string L. So now we calculate third one. Now we calculate L is equals to lambda by 2, lambda by 2, lambda by 2. So here LCM 2, that is equals to lambda plus lambda plus lambda, that is equals to 3 lambda by 2. L is equals to, that is equals to 3 lambda is equals to 2L. Lambda is equals to 2L by 3. Lambda is equals to 2L by 3. So, again we will repeat the frequency of frequency nu is equals to nu 2 is equals to V by lambda. Here again V is equals to root T by nu and lambda is equals to 2L by 3. So therefore nu 2 is equals to, what is the value of V? V is equals to root T by nu, root T by nu, and lambda is equals to 2L by 3, that is equals to 3 by 2L into root T by nu. Okay, so now discuss nu 2 is equals to 3 nu 1. Nu 2 is equals to 3 nu 1. Why? Here 1 by 2L into root T by nu is equals to fundamental frequency, that is denoted nu. So therefore nu 2 is equals to 3 nu 1. Okay, so therefore this is said to be the third harmonic or second overtone. Okay, here nu 2 is called as third harmonic or second overtone. So now along the string is vibrated some p modes, that is equals to nu p is equals to p by 2l into root t by nu. Okay, now the string is along this way. At p modes nu p is equals to p by 2l into root t by nu. Here p is said to be number of modes in a string. P is indicating number of modes in a string, and here l is said to be length of the string, t is said to be tension of the string, and nu is said to be linear density of the string. Okay, so now the ratio of fundamental frequencies are harmonics. The ratio of harmonics, that can be written as nu 1 is to nu 2 is to nu 3 is equals to, so on, is equals to 1 is to 2 is to 3. This is the ratio of harmonics of the structure string. This is very very important bit also. So what is the ratio of harmonics in a structure string? That is nu 1 is to nu 2 is to nu 3 along nu p, that is equals 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to along p. Okay, so this is the formation of harmonics or overtones in a structure string. This is very very important, one of the 8 mark question. Okay, now we discuss. So this this question is continued. So next one, loss of transverse waves. Loss of transverse waves. So here three losses are enclosed. First one, nu is inversely proportional 1 by L. In a structure string, the tension and linear density kept constant, the frequency of the string is always inversely proportional to the length of the string. That is, nu is inversely proportional to 1 by L, or nu L is equals to constant. This is the first law. This is called as first law of transfer wave. Okay, then first law of transfer waves. And second one, nu is proportional to root T. Here length and linear density kept constant. In a stretched string, length and linear density kept constant, the frequency of the stretched string is always directly proportional to the root of the tension. Root of the tension. That is, mu is proportional to root t. So that is said to be mu by root t equals to constant. Mu by root t is equals to constant. This is the second law of transverse waves. Okay. So now we discuss parallel. Parallel means mu is inversely proportional to 1 by root mu. 1 by root mu. So that is, here tension and length kept constant. The length of the stretched string and tension of the stretched string is always kept constant. The frequency of the stretched string is always inversely proportional to the square of the linear density. That is, mu is inversely proportional to 1 by root mu. So that is equals to mu into root mu is equals to constant. So this is the parallel of transfer wave in a stretched string. Okay, this is total one of the 8 mark question. Okay, so this is the three laws of transfer waves. First one, mu is proportional to 1 by L, and second one, mu is inversely proportional to 1 by L. This is the first law, and second law, mu is proportional to root t. Second law, here L and mu constant, and third law, t and L kept constant. The frequency of the stretched string is always inversely proportional to that square root of the linear density. That is, mu is proportional to 1 by root mu, or mu into root mu is equals to constant. This is the three laws of transverse waves. Okay.